Hello there. In this video, I will discuss on data collection for intrusion detection systems. So, for host-based intrusion detection system, there is two kind of data someone can collect. One is audit logs, and another is system call sequences. And for network-based IDS systems, simple network management protocol data and capture the packet. People can capture the packets and analyze the packet header and payloads. So few publicly available data sets are there. For example, CAIDA, which is a corporate association for internet data analysis. It is mainly involves denial of service attack. 2007, it was released. Then Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory dataset and ICSI dataset. Why datasets are important? Reason is that we need a repeatability on the experiment, validation of new approaches, a comparison of different approaches, parameter tuning, and dimensionality of the number of features. Okay. And other requirements are requirement of the data, what kind of data we should collect. The data should be real world, completeness in labeling, okay, correctness in labeling, sufficient trace size, concrete features extraction, diverse attack scenarios, and ratio between normal and attack traffic. So here are some existing data sets data set can be generated synthetically. That means by simulation you can generate some data set. There is some benchmark data set and there is some real life data sets which are available online. Okay, so in benchmark you will say KDD CAP 99, NSL KDD DARPA 2000, EFCON, CAIDAS, LBLN, and endpoint. These are the benchmark dataset. And real life, you will find UNIBS, ISX, CX, UNB. These are the real life dataset which are available for intrusion detection works. Now, KDD CAP 99 dataset was released in 1999 and still it is in use. I'm not going through all this text. You can just read out it. Then benchmark dataset KDD CAP 99 have basically four kind of data in it. Denial of service data, remote to local attack data, and user to root attack data, and surveillance of or probing dataset. Now there is another data set called NSL KDD, which is a reduced version of KDD CAP 99. In this, basically the duplicate data, redundant data sets are reduced and republished. Then DARPA 2000, it is another data set released by DARPA in 2000. It is having mainly distributed DOS attack and probing data sites. Then DEFCON is another one, you can just read out it. And CAIDA is another one. It was published by Center for Applied Network Data Analysis in 2007. Then Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory released another data site. Then endpoint dataset is also, another name is endpoint dataset, which is also available online. And UNIBS dataset is also available online, which you can collect if you want to analyze based on this dataset. And ISCX UNB dataset is also available. KU dataset, Kaito University dataset, this is also available. And here you can see the list of features in KDD CAP 99 dataset. Okay, so I'm not reading them out. Basically, I can tell you one thing. These basic features belongs to the header of the dataset, and content-based features are mainly based on the content in the packets captured. Okay, then time based is mainly few parts are part of the header and some parts are need to be captured from the network. And connection based feature, few are again part of your header and few are basically detected from the router from where it is the packets are traced. So thank you for watching.